We introduce a multi-tapping modification to a commercially available resistive flex sensor to capture local curvature changes. This modification enables high-resolution shape estimation. Additionally, we incorporate an FEM mesh model to account for device actuation to enhance our robot's sensing ability. This further expands functionality and utility of the sensor. Soft robots offer an exciting potential due to their compliance and adaptability, making them safer and more versatile for practical tasks. However, accurately perceiving their own shape and state, known as proprioception, remains a challenge in this field. In our work, we present a new approach to address this challenge, especially for soft robots with tight packaging constraints that rely on internal sensors. Thuruthal et al. Proposed in 2019 a custom soft strain sensor made of PDMS and carbon nanotubes embedded within a pneumatically actuated soft robotic finger. They relied on recurrent neural networks to learn the characteristics of this sensor and to thereby estimate the shape of the finger and external forces. While this approach demonstrated accurate estimation, such a purely data-driven approach might be limited to shapes within the scope of the training dataset, and also might not generalize outside the region directly observable by the sensors. In our previous work, we proposed a method for accurate force estimation in soft robots using an FEM model incorporating fiber reinforcement and pneumatic actuation. We created a detailed FEM model of a multi-segment soft robotic arm and integrated the sensor model for orientation measurement, achieving an average force estimation error of around 1.2%. The deformation of the robot in this case, however, is not directly observable, and it relies on an external motion capture system. In this work, we propose to augment an off-the-shelf resistive flex sensor, shown here in red, to enable a more accurate representation of the sensor shape compared to approaches using a constant curvature assumption. We also combined our augmented sensor with FEM modeling to implement shape proprioception, even beyond the sensor range. By integrating these techniques, we aim to accurately estimate the complex deformation in soft robots, especially under strict packaging constraints. We chose to use a resistive flex sensor from SpectraSymbol for its compactness and sensitivity. However, the sensor has limited resolution, providing only one measurement per sensor for over a length of 10 centimeters. To overcome this limitation, we introduce multi-tapping, which creates multiple electrical connections along the sensor. This modification allows us to measure sensor output by segments and extract additional information about the deformation, increasing our ability to infer a more detailed deformation state of the sensor. This modified sensor can be easily fabricated. First, we 3D print a thin mask with open windows. We then place the mask on the sensor and apply conductive silver epoxy over the mask to fill all the open windows. Once the epoxy has been applied, we remove the mask and position the flexible PCB on top of the sensor, aligning against the conductive epoxy segments and allowing it to cure for 15 minutes at 80 degrees Celsius. It can be seen here that the simple process of multi-tapping using this flexible PCB interface allows us to capture complex deformation states more effectively. We embed the sensor within the soft body and attach a series of markers to the surface. As the soft body deforms under actuation, the sensor will output varying resistance measurements, while a camera tracks the movement of the markers to describe the deformation. Using this data, we train a sensor model to map the resistance to sensor shape. During evaluation, we apply this model to estimate the shape of the soft body and the external forces. We can then validate our estimation by comparing them with measurements from a force torque sensor. Here, we have an overview of our system. We built the robot model using the finite element method within the SOFA framework. Assuming quasi-static dynamics, the known external forces such as gravity, internal elastic forces as defined by Hooke's law, and the boundary forces including unknown external forces, all sum up to zero. Therefore, if we introduce a function, sigma, that maps FEM nodes to robot states, we can then formulate an optimization problem to estimate external forces. In this optimization problem, we will find an optimal lambda that in this case represents external forces that minimize the difference between the simulated shape and the measured shape. This lambda will thus be an estimate of the external force that best explains the observed deformation. We will demonstrate our approach, first, in shape estimation using a soft flexible strip. We manually apply forces to deform this strip and record the changes in resistance and the corresponding shape. This allows us to train the sensor model. The multi-tapped sensor, combined with our FEM-based modeling approach, allows us to estimate the shape of this soft flexible strip with approximately 3% average relative error. This approach even extends to the features in the soft body that are not directly observable by the sensor. Then, we estimate both shape and force for a soft finger. Similar to the flexible strip, we actuate the finger with varying pressures while applying external forces by hand to record the resistance and shape data needed to train the model. Additionally, to test our approach on the soft finger, we use a robotic arm with a force torque sensor at its end effector to apply forces accurately and thereby serve as the ground truth. Furthermore, our model can take into account the provided actuation input. In our experiment with the pneumatically actuated soft finger, this allows us to estimate external forces over a range of 5 newtons with approximately 11% average relative error. Here is a summary of our work on multi-tapping flex sensors for accurate proprioception and force estimation. Thank you for your attention. Please refer to our paper for further details.